What's going on, nerds? RendoRage here. Thank you so much for tuning in to episode 2 of Double Chest of Every Item. Now, I've been doing a lot of offline work. Now, as you can see behind me, I've built myself a villager trading hall. This is something I knew I needed from the very beginning, so I had to work on that. In the little house was a villager breeding place. Now, over here, I've got these traders for the glass panels. This will help me. Now, I've got a zombificationator here. Yeah, I did call it that, where I can put my little villagers in there and give them the weakness potion and golden apples. I'm trying to divide them into sections. So as you can see here, I've got smite. I've got all the enchantments in this section. You know, as you can see, you've got silk touch there as well. So I've got one here. I'm trying to move them around, but at the moment I've got these two. I need them for the golden carrots. It's a work in progress, but I've got what I need at the moment. And I will work on completing it in the future, but I have what I need at the moment. So, moving on, I do want to show you some other things. For example, to the left, yes, up here, I have built a farm for my partner. If you come up here, I made a nice little staircase. I'm just going to ignore the witch. But yeah, nice little farm here. It's quite nice. I've got sunflowers. I've got the, you know, they've got all the plants and everything we need. But yeah, it looks quite nice. I think for partial freehand, I think this is a nice little touch. And as you can see, I've got all the resources that I need. And yeah, going back to the farm, you can see that I have everything to breed them as well. So yeah, it's quite nice. But we'll see. We'll see how my partner thinks of it when she uses it in the future. But moving on. Here we have the villager breeding hall. As you can see, it's a pretty simple design, so I'm just going to jump over it. But down here is the iron golem farm. Yeah, the iron golems burn there. It's pretty simple. They all fall down. You know, zombies are in the middle. Villagers along the outside. Yeah, that's just generally how it works. Yeah, this is what I've accumulated so far. As you can see, there's quite a lot there, considering I have taken some out and I'm just moving the poppies out of the way now. But yeah, I've accumulated a lot. It's all you need, really, especially for a one-man army. It helps me out a lot. So we have a lot to do today. Now, the whole premise of this video is to collect a double chest of every item in the game. So I'm not going to be showing you a lot of the building process, but just to get the whole collection started. Now, just as an example, I removed all of the village structures around the area, some being over here and some just underneath as well, but here is a time-lapse of it. Additionally, we have taken down this building just next to this one up here, so right here, and then you have another one here. I'm going to keep that one just for like a fish barn, but eventually I'm planning on taking this building down and replacing it as my own, and I want to build some streets as well. Not sure what to do about this one though. I may revamp it or just completely get rid of it. I haven't made my mind yet, but I want to keep that because that's got my nether portal there. And, you know, it's quite a nice structure. I'm going to keep that one, I think. But I have been collecting some resources as well because I do want to create a street, you know, an actual road and pavements as well. I feel like I want to follow that vibe to my build this season. So, yeah, as you can see, I've got some bits and bobs here. I haven't arranged it yet just because I haven't made the storage area. I think I'm going to leave it as is until I create the storage area, but you know, I've got everything here. I mean, the base design of this street and the pavement, I'm going to make granite based. Now, I understand it's a bit gross, but it's polished granite. So I've got, you know, I've been doing again some offline resource gathering just so I can create the street and actually make the place look more of a village rather than just a building built into like a village area. On another note, I do have a design that I want to follow for this storage unit. Now, it's going to be about enough. If it doesn't, I could just always fit more. But right now, I haven't really thought about where I want to do it. Tell you what, actually, let's try and find an area for it. So, I want something in a cave, you know, that I don't have to build the outside of the area as well. So, I'm thinking, maybe around here. Let me have a look. Probably about there, I think. Maybe, yeah, there. I think that will fit quite well. Let me go build the entrance, actually. Let me see how it looks. If you can guess the design of the storage unit, then props to you. I will show that in the next video, because I think that's what my plan is for the next video. However, just to give you a hint for this one, I'm going to let you know that it is 17 blocks in, 17 blocks to the left, and 17 blocks to the right. If you've already built this yourself, you probably do understand it already, but the entrance is going to be 7 wide, 7 deep, and 10 high. Please just understand the sheer scale of this operation. I am going to collect a double chest of every item in the game, not just the single item, an entire stack of it, if it is stackable. So for example, the Ender Pearls, there's only 16, so it'll be a 16 stack and a double chest worth. But that's relatively easy, because you can get a farm for that. But for example, netherite ingots, netherite scraps, netherite blocks, ancient debris, netherite gear, netherite tools, everything, like actually everything, every single item that you see in the interface that you can obtain through normal Minecraft, survival Minecraft, I will be collecting. I don't care how long this takes, I don't care how long the series is going to take, that is what I plan on doing. Now, I do need to mention that there is an issue with this video. The issue is that these clips that I have recorded, some of them have been muted. I'm not entirely sure why. It may be my fault, and, you know, I may be stupid, you know, and I didn't press the, you know, record audio button. But, nonetheless, I've made the progress, so I can't go back. I can't start again. I can't press re-record. I've already started the progress. So here is another time-lapse of me just creating the template without a beacon. I don't know why I started it. I should have gotten a beacon, but here you go, I guess. Enjoy the time-lapse. Right, okay, so I think it's time that we start getting those wither skeleton skulls. Now, it's going to be a little bit difficult. As you know, wither skeleton skull farming is very hard, but I've managed to get myself a sword with looting 3 and smite 5, mending and unbreaking, so I'm all ready to go. I just have to brave it and get those skeletons the hard way. Now, I really want to do something about this. Maybe I'm thinking probably put like a little castle thing here, but like have stairs that are coming down from there, and then probably have it the other way as well, so it goes all the way around, so you get like an aerial view. Plus, it will make it significantly easier for me to jump over as well. But enough procrastinating. I actually think we need to go to the Nether, so it's about time we go. I need to get this with the skeleton skulls somehow, and the only way of actually doing it is by, well, you guessed it correctly, doing it. So let's get going. Okay, now if I remember correctly, the Nether fortress should be okay. This one. No. Ah! Okay, here it is. Right. Okay. Yeah, this is definitely the way. Now, I have been doing some offline work in the Nether as well. I needed to find where the Nether Fortress was, so this is why I dug the tunnel. At the end of the tunnel, to the left, is where the Nether Fortress is. So, luckily for me, it was a pretty quick find. I placed some blocks down so I could jump over the soul sand, but as you can see, that didn't work out the best. But we got there in the end. I did find it, and all we got to do is just get some with the skeleton skulls. Well, this wasn't a good idea. Not at all. I had to get out of the corner. Nice. Good start. Right, let's do this again. Nope, nothing here. Been here about a good solid 30 minutes now. Hey!
Send shivers down your spine. Shrieking skulls will shock your soul till your doom tonight. Spooky, scary skeletons.
Anyway, time to get two more. Nope, none here. Or here. Well, I got a second, but I wasn't recording. Of course. Nope, none here. Or here. Or here. Well, I got my third, but I died. Which is very annoying. And I have to go collect it. But problem is, I'm up against this guy. What do I do? Is he stuck? He is stuck. Okay. Alright. Come up again. Yes! Finally. I got it. That is a relief! I can actually go do what I want to now. This took me like, what? A couple of hours? Yeah, time well spent. Not. Needless to say, I've got what I want. It's time to get out of here. Now, for this trick, let me get a quick light source. I think there's a torch up here. But this trick, I actually learned from a YouTuber called Grian. If you haven't subscribed to him, please do. I actually watch him pretty much all the time. I find him quite entertaining. But I learned this from him, actually. Iron golems are really effective against the wither. Now, if you go to a place that is less explosive, such as Deep Slate, and you place a whole bunch of golems down, and the wither skeleton, the iron golems will win. So, yeah, what I'm doing now is creating a 3x3 of deep slate, so I can actually place the iron golems down, and also the wither. I want to make sure that it's actually pretty deep in, because I don't want the wither to escape. And then I create a 2x1 entrance, and then another 3x3x3, so I can actually place the wither in there. But overall, I think we are practically ready. Just got to make sure this area is fully open. I can place the soul sand down and the wither skeleton skulls, and then we're good to go. Just this last bit left. Okay, here we go. Where's the soul sand? There it is. Pop that in place. There we go. Okay, I want to make sure I get the iron golems first. So, let's get the box. There we go. And again. And again. And egg. Okay, let me fix that. There we go. Okay. I need to place these heads. So, I need to just create another little section for me to run past. I don't want to get stuck with the wither skeleton. That would suck. There we go. Okay, let's get this started. So, do I have the pumpkin heads? Yes, where is it? There it is. Okay, carved pumpkin. Perfect. Right, one, two. Here we go. Oh, come on, really? Where's my axe? Oh, it's in the other one. Fair enough. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. There you go. They start attacking the wither. What are you doing? What are you doing? Go fight. Why are you standing there? Just go. This way. What are you doing? Go. Just go. Fight him. Fight. Do your job. That's what I created you to do. Never mind, it's dead anyway. Oh, that's a lot of deep slate as well. Okay, I have a nice... Okay, let me get rid of that. There we go, another star. Let's go. Right, which one was the way out? Okay, I think it's this way. Thanks, Mr. Golem. Okay, this is the most exciting part. We actually get to create the beacon, so we can place the beacon down, and then we can actually get the storage unit. Ah, this is so exciting. Okay, all that's left to do is collect the iron blocks from my iron farm, which should be enough. I think there is definitely enough in there, so let me go and check that now for you. Just creating some space so I can actually fit the iron blocks in there. Oh, more than enough. Ah, yes. Let's see. If I remember correctly, it was 2 stacks and 36, I think. Okay, I need more iron blocks. Oh, yeah. Wait, why am I not just clicking? There we go. Perfect. Let's create as much as I can. And now for the final part. There is my entrance. Now I just need to create my beacon. Where am I gonna put it? Now, save me from breaking more blocks. I'll just place it out in the water. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Perfect. Let me just fill that in now. And then after that, it's 7x7. Let me try and do this in threes. Nope, that didn't work out. Go. Okay, there's 64 blocks already. It really doesn't feel that much. Why did I just break that block? Anyway. Okay, this is relatively easier now. I don't have to worry about falling in the water. There you go. Perfect. Oh, that was an accident. I ran out of... again, that's another stack. Definitely need to break that one. That one's out of place. Lovely. Why am I still breaking these blocks? I am not doing so well. But that's that complete. Pop that on. Activate. And let's get haste too. There it is. Perfect. So we have created ourselves a beacon. So now I can actually create this storage room, storage unit. So with that being said, I'm actually going to end the episode there. So thank you very, very, very much for watching. Please stay tuned for episode 3, where I'm actually going to be creating the storage unit and begin collecting. So essentially what I'm going to do is work on this section here. I'm probably going to get rid of all of this up here. And then I probably need to work on the left and right a bit as well. And that should get all of it there. So thank you all for watching. Like and subscribe. And I will see you nerds in the next episode. See ya.